earlier on the program, Pam dropped by, and now our good friend Jack is here. And so is Patrick from Algonquin College. How are you?
Good. How are you
good,
today?
Good, good. We got some great Thanksgiving weekend ideas. Something a little different.
Hey? Yeah, yeah. Well, it's our students are in the heart of their program right now.
Yeah.
They're looking forward to the long weekend.
Now, did a lot of the students start in the fall? They're full on in now, 6 weeks in.
Everybody is 6 weeks in and working hard,
yeah.
Doing really well. And right now they're looking forward to going home and have a little Thanksgiving dinner to
yeah.
show.
Yeah, but, that's right. They'll be cooking at home, no doubt.
That's expected.
Is that right? Is that part of the idea, the homework, as it were?
No, it's every mom and dad.
Yeah. If we send you there to learn how to cook, you better cook when you get home.
That's exactly
right. All right. We're making some cool mashed potatoes, right?
Yeah, we have a Jack Daniel's sweet potato mash that we're going to do today.
Wow.
And as well, we're going to do a Brussels sprouts that are actually edible.
The vegetable really that nobody likes.
That's right. So what we want to do here for our Jack Daniel's mashed potato.
Yeah.
First thing we're going to do is reduce down a little Jack Daniel's.
Okay.
When you're cooking with alcohol, you get a burning alcohol flavor in your throat if
yeah.
you don't cook the alcohol off out of the
So you want the alcohol out, you want the flavor to stay.
That's right.
Okay,
so we boil that away and it doesn't take very long. Just heat it up. Alcohol goes away, gets rid of that raw alcohol.
But it must reach the boiling point.
It should, yeah.
Yeah, to get rid of the alcohol.
That's right.
Okay.
That's right. So we're going to start with that today.
Okay.
Now with our sweet potatoes, go to any market, grocery store, we get a lovely sweet potato. Beautiful time of year for sweet potatoes. And all you have to do for this dish, put them in the oven hole.
Just like they are.
Don't have to cut them up or anything.
Really?
Just going to pull these guys out of the oven here.
Okay, just like that.
Yeah, they're all nice and soft.
Okay.
And
do sweet potatoes cook faster than regular?
These guys take about an hour and a half in the oven.
Okay.
And they're nice and soft. You want to be able to squeeze them, feel them very soft.
Okay.
Now, of course, they're hot. Use a nice clean towel for that.
Yeah, exactly.
All right. And
we turn that off. It's unlocked. Hang on.
There we go.
I'll unlock it for you.
Oh, there we go.
Come on now. There we go. And then you want this one on?
Yeah, there we go.
Come on, bad boy.
Well, we can carry on here very easily.
Okay.
And what we would have done, we'll have cooked off our alcohol.
Then
we're going to add a little cream in there.
Okay.
35% cream.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to have a little swirl, mix that up. Let that warm up with our potato. Very simply, we're just going to open them up.
Oh, just like that.
Scrape the potato out.
Oh.
And it's already mashed for you.
Yeah, it's already nice and soft and ready to go.
Nice and soft, just in here with our,
okay.
with our Jack Daniel's and cream.
So scoop out as many potatoes as you would possibly need.
Scoop out what you need.
Yeah.
Mix that together.
Right.
And we're going to have a beautiful flavored Jack Daniel's sweet potato mash.
Okay. And now I guess you've got that somewhere, don't you?
We're just going to do that one here.
Okay.
But, we'll get that done real quick. Only takes a couple of minutes maximum to get this done.
Now, how much Jack do you use as opposed to the potatoes you use?
Well, that's up to you. Now, you want to make sure that you keep a good consistency with the potato.
Very good.
If you put too much liquid, you're going to it'll be a runny mess.
Now, when you're teaching students at Algonquin, is Thanksgiving mealtime one of the things that you're instructing them on?
Our program is geared towards classical French cooking, so there's no real Thanksgiving in there.
Right.
However, with the Restaurant International, we try to vary our menu a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
So for the holiday season, we'll make sure we have Thanksgiving things there.
Yeah.
And our students who are cooking in the restaurant will be serving food that has some relation.
Are they working in the restaurant on the long weekend, or is it closed?
It'll be open Saturday, Friday, Saturday, closed Monday.
Yeah, and people can come by for meals, right?
That's right.
Yeah. Make sure you do that, because you're getting a great... great sample of what the students are up to and encouraging them at the same time, right?
That's right, absolutely. And we need the feedback.
Yeah.
And one of the most important things we have to teach and we all have to be aware of as chefs, listen to your customer.
Exactly.
It's critical that you do, because what you want to do isn't always what the customer wants to eat.
Exactly. All right, we're going to take a break. Patrick's going to stick around because he's found something good to do with the Brussels sprout. The vegetable most hated by all. We'll be back with that more after this here on CTV Morning Live. Don't go away.